When Canada hosted the G8 meeting in Muskoka in 2010, Prime Minister Stephen Harper put maternal and child health at the top of the agenda. It's become his number one development priority, and he went even further today. As Mike Lecouture reports from Senegal, Canada hopes the financial aid will be a shot in the arm for Africa's medical system.
Every year, 1.5 million children under the age of 5 die from a disease that could have been easily prevented with a simple vaccine. Now, these newborns will not become one of those statistics, thanks to the free medicine given out at this maternal health clinic in Dakar. It's important because it's good for my 2-month-old's health and for mine too, says this mother.
Canada will make a considerable financial contribution.
Last spring, the Harper government pledged $3.5 billion for maternal health, and today earmarked $500 million of that amount to administer the much-needed rotavirus vaccine to newborns. The money reinforces Canada's commitment to child and maternal health.
The global reduction of child deaths that we have seen, from nearly 12 million to 6.5 million between 1990 and 2012, is due in large part to the scale-up of essential vaccines.
The organization supplying the vaccines hopes other countries follow Canada's lead.
The share of Canada is going to be about 5%, which is appropriate to its size given what it does in other international fora.
Our workers here say at this clinic alone, they immunize 50 kids per week, saving up to 200 lives per month. And they say it makes a world of difference.
People have seen the necessity of vaccinating their children, says this midwife, because sicknesses have decreased as a result of the programs. Now, that education has helped, especially when it comes to the Ebola crisis. In countries like Senegal, the outbreak is pushing people to get vaccinated for other diseases.
The whole Ebola crisis has brought back to the public consciousness the need for us to deal with infectious diseases.
And now that vaccination campaigns are part of the norm, it's hoped health systems here can be strengthened so that children in this part of the world have a fighting chance. Mike Lecouture, Global News, Dakar, Senegal.